Hello students, today we are going to read our lesson 4, A Special Gift. Now let's start. Little Women is a delightful story about the March sisters, Meg, Jaw, Beth and Amy. In this excerpt, we read about how the March family find time for joy and thanksgiving despite their problems and celebrate a joyous Christmas. As Christmas neared, there was an air of excitement in the house, as this was going to be an unusually happy Christmas for all of them. Jaw and Lori, their next door neighbor, ran about mysteriously and could be heard laughing beyond the hedge. Now the next page. When Christmas Day came at last, it brought good tidings of great joy. Mr. March had written that he would soon be with them, while Beth felt well enough to sit by the window, wrapped in the bright red shawl Mother had gifted her. And in the garden stood a beautiful snow maiden that Jaw and Lori had made. And then they gathered in the parlor to open their presents. "I think this is the best Christmas ever," said Jaw, hugging the storybook she had always wanted and waiting for a chance to read it in the attic. "I think so too," added Amy, staring at the framed picture her mother had given her. "I agree," said Meg, smoothing down the soft folds of her first silk dress. Mr. Lawrence, Lori's grandfather, had gifted it to her. "And I do too," said Mother, looking from Beth's smiling face to Mr. March's letter in her hand. "Oh, what a wonderful Christmas. If only Father were here, my happiness would be complete," sighed Beth, as Jaw carried her off to the study to rest for a while after the morning's excitement. Sometimes in this work-a-day world, things do happen as they do in storybooks, and what a comfort it is. For just as the March family had settled down for some quiet time together, Lori opened the parlor door and popped his head in very quietly. His face was so full of excitement and his voice sounded so joyful that everyone was startled, though he only said, "Here is another present for the March family." Now the next page. And in came a tall man leaning on the arm of Mr. Brooke, Lori's tutor. Great excitement and confusion followed. Mr. March became invisible in the embrace of four pairs of loving arms. Jaw almost fainted with joy and clung to Lori for support. Mr. Brooke kissed Meg in all the hugging and kissing, and Amy tripped over a stool and did not even bother to get up. She hugged her father's legs and wept for joy. Mrs. March was the first to recover. She held up her hand with a warning, "Hush, remember Beth." But it was too late. The door of the study flew open and a pale girl in a red shawl flew straight into her father's arms. Joy had given strength to her wobbly legs. Mr. March settled down on the big chair. His heart was filled with happiness. When fine weather came and the doctor said I could go home, I longed to be with you for Christmas and told Brooke I would like to surprise you. I couldn't have been here if he hadn't seen to the travel arrangements, said Mr. March, happy to be with his family again. What a great lunch they had after that. Hannah, their cook, had baked delicious recipes, and the plum pudding melted in the mouth. Mr. Lawrence, Lori, and Mr. Brooke also joined them. Next page. Laurie had planned a sleigh ride in the afternoon, but the girls would not leave their father. So the guests left early, and the family sat together around the fire. "Just a year ago, we were groaning over a sad Christmas without father. Do you remember?" asked Joe. "It's been quite a pleasant year on the whole," said Meg, smiling at the fire. "I think we have had a bad year that is ended well," observed Amy. "I'm glad it's over and we have got you back, father," whispered Beth as she sat on her father's knee. "We have been through a lot of trouble in the past year, my children, but you have done very well. You have been a great support to mother, and I want to thank you for it," said Mr. March, looking with fatherly satisfaction at the four young faces gathered around him. Mrs. March, her heart full of joy and gratitude, did not feel the need to say anything at all. "It's singing time now," said Beth, as she went slowly towards her dear little piano, "and I want to be in my usual place. I'll try to sing one of Father's favorites." And with that, she softly touched the keys and sang in the sweet voice they had thought they would never hear again. Now, this chapter, this story was written by Loisa May Alcott. She was an American novelist, best known as the author of the novel Little Women and its sequels, Good Wives, Little Men, and Jaws Boys. Her books focus on family and relationships. Now, this was our lesson, a special gift. That's all for the day.